Hello friends, welcome to TextStudySell. In this video, we'll make a very useful home automation system using the NodeMCU to control all the appliances with Google Assistant and from the Alexa app. And you can also control the appliances manually with switches and monitor the real-time status in the Google Home and Alexa app. Let me show you how it works. Hey Google, turn on all the lamps.
All right, turning three lights on.
Hey Google, turn off room light.
All right, turning off the room light.
Alexa, turn on room light.
Okay.
Alexa, turn off night lamp.
Okay.
Hey Google, turn on night lamp.
Okay, turning on the night lamp.
Thus, you can easily control the appliances from anywhere in the world using the Google Assistant and Alexa. And you don't need any Alexa device like Echo Dot or Google Home for this project. You can just use their Android app. Now, let me control the appliances manually from the switches. And you can see I can easily control all the appliances. Now, let me turn off the internet and show you how it works without internet. I have turned off the Wi-Fi so I can control these lamps only from the manual switches, and there is some delay as you can see. After I turn off the switch, it will take some time. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, the NodeMCU will automatically connect with the Wi-Fi, and then we can control the appliances both from Google Assistant and Alexa. Let me show you. Hey Google, turn off night lamp.
Okay, turning the night lamp off.
Hey Google, turn off room light.
Turning off the room light.
So thus you can easily control the appliances with Alexa, Google and from manual switches. And you can make this project without using any custom design PCB. You just have to use a NodeMCU and a relay module to make this project. And during the video, I will share the complete circuit diagram code for this project. So you can easily make this project for your home. Let's get started. To make this project, we just need a NodeMCU, a 4-channel relay module, and you can use the existing switchboard or push button. Now you have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. As you can see, the circuit is very simple. I have connected these switches across the GPIO pin and the ground pin, and this is the AC circuit, and this is live and this is neutral wire. Please take proper safety precaution while connecting these appliances with the relay module. Now if you use push button instead of switches, then you have to refer this circuit. And again, I have connected these push buttons across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to give the project a professional look, I have designed a PCB for this project and ordered it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with three simple steps. First, upload the GABA file, then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color, then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the components on the PCB. Now let me connect the NodeMCU with the PCB. Now before uploading the code, I have to configure the Sinric account. For that, I will use Sinric Pro, and you have to visit this page. I have mentioned the link in the description. Then click on sign up, and you have to mention all these details to create an account. I already have an account in Sinric Pro, so I will click on login and enter the credential and then click on login. This is the dashboard. First, we'll go to rooms, and here I will add one room. You can give any name, but I am giving living room, and then click on save. So our room created. Then we will go to devices. So here I am using the free version, so I can add maximum 3 devices. First we have to click on add devices, then give the name of the device. I am giving room light. Device type will be switch, and I will select the room as living room. Then I will click on next. Now if you want any notification related to that device, then you can turn it on. I don't need that notification, and again I will tap on next, and then I will click on save. Our device is created. In similar way, I will create the next two devices. So I have created these devices, and each device has a unique ID, you can see, which will be required in the code. Now we can program the NodeMCU for this project. This is the code for this project. You can download this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description. Then you can download the code from this button. And in this code, I have mentioned all the required link where you can download the board and libraries, or you can also visit this page. And here you can see they have mentioned all the required library. You need Sinric Pro, Arduino JSON, and WebSocket libraries. After doing that, you have to mention the Wi-Fi credential. Here you have to mention the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password. Then you have to mention the app key and app secret. So if you go to your Sinric account, in the credential you will find the app key and app secret. You just have to copy this, and then here you have to paste the app key and the app secret. After that, you have to mention the device ID for each device. So let me enter the device ID. Again, I have to go to the Sinric account and go to device. Now we have to copy the device ID. Let me copy it. Then I have to paste it here. So thus you have to enter the device ID for all three devices. And here you can see these are the GPIO pin I have used for this project. Now if you use switch, then you have to comment this line, but if you use push button, then just uncomment this line. You can use same code for the push button. So again, I have to comment it as I am using switch for this project. Now I can upload this code to NodeMCU. For that, I will go to tools, select the board as NodeMCU 1.0 and the proper port. Then I can hit the upload button. Now I will configure the Amazon Alexa app. So let me open the Alexa app, and in the device you can see there is no device connected. Now I will tap on more and select the skills and games, and here I have to search for Sinric Pro. Then I will tap on the Sinric Pro. Now tap on the enable to use. Then you have to enter the Sinric credential. So here I will enter the email ID and the password which I have used for the Sinric. After that, tap on sign in. You can see Sinric Pro has been successfully linked. Now again I have to go to the Amazon Alexa app. Now I have to tap on discover devices. It will take some time, and during this time the NodeMCU should be connected with the Wi-Fi. Here you can see three devices found. So I have to go to device, and in the plug you can see these are the devices we have connected. Now let me configure the Google Home app for this project. So let me open the Google Home app. In this app, first I have to create a home. So I will tap on create home, and here I am giving the name smart home. You can give any name. Now tap on continue. The home is created. Now again I will tap on this plus icon and select the first option, setup device, and here I will select works with Google. Here you have to search for Sinric Pro, and then select the Sinric Pro. Again it will ask the Sinric credential, so you have to log in the Sinric account, then tap on sign in. After that you have to go to the home page of the app, and here you can see three devices connected in the living room. You can see these are the three devices: kitchen light, night lamp, and room light. Again I can control these devices from the Google Home app. I have connected all these four lamps with this relay module as per the circuit. Now let me turn on the 5 volt supply. Now if you use switch, Then there is one restriction that during the booting process of NodeMCU, this switch 2 must be turned off. But if you use push buttons, then there is no such restriction. Now let me control the appliances with the Google Assistant. Hey Google, turn on all lights.
Okay, turning 3 lights on.
So this is a very useful smart home system, and as I am using free version of Sinric Pro account, so I can control maximum 3 devices with the Google Home and Alexa app. And you can also join our Telegram channel Tech Study Cell to get different home automation ideas. If you like this project, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such projects. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.